Greetings, everybody. Rodimon here. Thank you for tuning in to the very first episode of a brand new series of RimWorld called Escape the Tomb World, which is the RimWorld miniseries marathon winner for May. If you want more details about this series or to try it out yourself, information can be found in the description of the video. If you'd like to skip the overview, please use the chapter's link. Let's get started. Episode 1, Man Cave. Welcome to Escape the Tomb World. Before I start, I wanted to mention why I'm doing this series and what it is about. So Escape the Tomb World is a result of a public poll determining my miniseries marathon for May. It was suggested originally by a patron and then voted on by all of you, or whomever wanted to partake in the vote, as it was a public poll on YouTube community. And, well, it won. So let's go over the very simple rules. This series is a lot more simple than the series that I have in the past, and it's intentional. So the mod list is super straightforward. Almost all of the mods there do absolutely nothing in terms of game mechanics, except for Radworld. Radworld is more or less the only mod that is changing fundamental gameplay. All the rest of those mods are just UI mods and things like that. The rule, I don't even have rules, it's rule and goal. I and Yoda must survive. In the case that either of us or both of us die, and there's no Resurrector Mexurum around, we have to save scum. It's allowed, but the result of save scumming means that the threat scale increases. So every time I bite the bullet, I, you know, save scum, but it gets a little harder. And the goal is to leave the planet via the AI ship, the pre-built ship that you have to travel to. The scenario is Rich Explorer, but slightly modified. Modified, and I'll show you here. So I modified the Rich Explorer to disable a whole bunch of incidents that don't really make sense for Tomb World, like Self-Tame or Ambrosia Sprouts, that kind of stuff. People don't show up randomly on my map tile, and I don't get random resources either. And then back to the rules briefly. Nope, that's the be right back. The storyteller is random, losing his fun with possibly higher threat skill. So before I jump in, I also want to explain a little bit what Radworld is. Radworld is a mod that introduces radiation. So if you take a look at this little world here, as you can see, it doesn't look the way you'd normally expect it to look. It does still have vanilla biomes. So there's still things like temperate forests or arid shrublands. The issue is, if you live there, it's incredibly high radiation, which can cause you to mutate and die. Some of the mutations are positive, like an extra arm or a larger ears that help you hear, but a lot of the mutations are negative and will make you ugly and deformed and slower and more useless. So it's really important that we stay protected from said radiation. And then there's also these new biomes. So you have caverns. Well, I'll go back a second. So these biomes have one of two settings. Either they protect you from radiation or they don't. So biomes, the vanilla biomes, do not protect you from radiation. Not even under mountains. So if I settled, for instance, in a temperate forest, which is mountainous, it wouldn't really matter. I would still get irradiated. And then the mod introduces new biomes, some of which will irradiate you and some of which won't. So we have things like surface caverns, which will irradiate you, and then regular caverns, which don't. I started in a regular cavern. There are better caverns than this called lush caverns, and they're full of plant life and mushrooms and the like. And then there are barren caverns, which are even harder. And then the mod also introduces some other sick biomes, sick caverns as well. Here's a sick cavern, and the sick caverns are like regular caverns, but they do irradiate you. So a huge part of this series is going to be trying to get to here. This is the landed ship that we can use to blast off into space. And as you can see, it happens to be on an island. So I can't walk there, I can't caravan there. And I'm starting here in a regular sized cavern. Just about around the equator, and this is what it looks like. Now, there's a lot of caveats to the regular caverns. For the mod maker, for whatever reason, introduced the caverns with thin rock roofs, but the roofs are not removable. So solar, wind, that kind of power is impossible. Literally impossible. The wildlife here is radiated and often dangerous, with a disproportionately high amount of wargs, mega spiders, and bears. There also can be regular old insect infestations as well, but because everything is thin rock roofing, you're not going to get traditional vanilla infestations as they require overhead mountain. So I think that's why it's a thin rock roof that is not removable for balancing purposes, so you don't get wiped by mass infestation. Another thing to note is because of the caverns, raiders take very interesting paths, right? So if we look to the south, for instance, southern raiders can only enter here and here. Very different mechanics than before. And then the only other mod in my mod list that changes anything is we have a Yoda. There he is. He's a 10-year-old multi-gray poo. He can guard and attack. He's basically a Yorkie, more or less. And this is where we're starting off. So step one, as you can see above my head, set up basic shelter. Oh, and I just realized I actually don't have the app that runs the death counter, because apparently I'm ill-prepared. It's a good start. Hopefully I won't have to use it though. So that noise there was me activating my Death Counter app, so sorry about that. All right. So the first thing I want to do here is to allow all, so that I have access to all of the materials that I landed with. Oh, and one other thing about the lore, if we're jumping back here real quick. I don't have lore. There is no lore. I was going to include lore that was like cheeky, like, hey, we woke up here, I don't know what's going on. But yeah, this is just one of the challenges. So first order of business is to make sure Yoda stays safe. So I'm gonna create a home, a little zone for him not to stray from. Right, dude? Gotta keep you safe. And more treats for you, of course. And give myself a charge rifle. So here's what I'm going to do. I am going to set up a bit of a perimeter wall, and holy moly, there is a lot going on. I'll catch up with that really soon, and I will have a lot of thank yous to say. My goodness. So what I'm doing is I'm just walling up the perimeter here so that I can keep hostile fauna out. I think that's going to be critically important to keep the hostile fauna out, or I will be eaten by something larger than I am and die. As far as work priorities, firefight, patient, basic, and then construct. Oh, I should also go over my own traits. I'm Rad Hale. Why my last name is Hale, I have no idea. But I have no passions, straight six across the board, quick sleeper, fast learner, and industrious. I didn't really know how to design myself. It's really strange to have to do that. So I gave myself some sort of random person, I guess. Oh, and I am a RimWorld exile. So y'all sent me here, and I'm trying to get back home. Let's go ahead and get the walls built ASAP. I'm also going to need colonist beds and start to farming and all of that. So let me update the goal here. Build a perimeter. Wargs and irradiated bears would good start. Botching. Wargs and irradiated bears would very quickly shred Yoda, and I don't know if my charge rifle would be able to protect him. So going for protection as soon as I can, I think, is a very good call. It also keeps them from wandering in and eating my pack of survival meals, because I will, of course, have a very dwindling amount of food pretty quickly here. And as soon as I have basic perimeter up, let me start going through this. Holy cow. So, play ice. thank you for the resub, as well as Not That Obvious and Terrazabug, Jazium and Diab, Seldon and Frank, Kamasia, Matt or Sven, and Arcmaster. Thank you for the resubs. And then, for Bits, Glitch, Morty, Kamasia twice over, and Kriv. And then for gifted subs, there is quite a lot of them. Where to start? Critical Foxes. I think I need to be pink already. I'm already a level 5 hype train. Mover, Lolan, Morty, Kadath. Oh boy. My time remaining up here is already... it's already pushing midnight. Oh boy, I do not like the fact that this Iridian Mega Spider is behind my walls. I was hoping to build them out, not keep them in. And also, Rad, come on. Dude, the amount of botching that you've done, it's embarrassing. You're embarrassing both of us. Oh, Lord. The perils of having a whopping 6 as a construction skill. When this is fully enclosed, I should be able to read it as an individual room. And there it is. So I'm enclosed. Next up, I'm going to set my hunt a little higher. And I'm just going to hunt everything that is inside my zone here. So that I can keep my own food provisions safe. So there seems to be just a mole and 2 rats. There's one. Old Mamino, thank you for the sub as well. And Bakabuletu, thank you for the follow. I'm gonna probably manually hunt. Okay, there we go, that's good. I was a little worried about hunting, shooting towards the rat where Yoda was standing, but it turned out okay. So now we have all of that stuff hunted, and I'm going to stockpile their corpses so that I can butcher them for food. And then the next big thing I'd like to do is to start growing. And I'm going to grow glow stools. So the mod introduces a whole lot of additional types of cave things for you to make for yourself. Glow stools and the like. So I'm going to start planting the glow stools after I construct myself a good bed. And then Mr. Yoda. Yeah, that's you, dude. Let's give you a little spot here too. And the Yoda cam is now unlocked. Just occurred to me that I had that locked. So in terms of the crops, I should explain a little bit. We have glowstools, which are glowing mushrooms that produce fungus. Rad fungus, which produces a special type of fungus. We've got angel strand, which produces cotton or cloth. Giant roots for wood. Cave ferns, which is kind of like grazables. Keel shroom, which is for herbal medicine. And that is what to expect out of the cave plantings. Oh, I didn't mean for this to be potatoes. All right. Next step is to get a steel butcher table. Why, you might ask, do I want to spend for a steel butcher table? It is because there is a lot to hunt here, but it's all dangerous fauna, right? So I want to make as much bang for my buck butchering as I can. And I don't want to spend a lot of time butchering, so I'm going to put the table here where the glow shrooms illuminate. But I'm actually going to forbid that because there's 2 days left for these irradiated animals to rot. And instead, let's go ahead with a research bench. And then also to enclose this area off to keep it cleaner with a door, which means I am going to move my bed out so that Mr. Little Yoda can join me. So we'll move this area here like that. And let's hope I don't fail construction like I have been. Another reason to have a enclosed zone like here is if I end up with some sort of heat wave, I can create a passive cooler and keep myself cool. Orange Chaos, thanks for the resub, as well as Spartan. And then thank you for the gifted sub, Orange, as well, and Stevie Viper for the resub as well. A whole lot of you. Holy moly. All right, down here. How light is it there? Dark, lit. I am going to put a stool in. Oops, a very small table. And start to do recreation. Actually, I want that here. Oh, and asleep we go. I'm going to have you all vote on first research project. So here are some of the options. Right at the start, we're able to manufacture what is called patchwork hazmat suits, which will temporarily protect us from radiation. In order to get better radiation protection, you need sterile materials. So sterile materials is an option here. Another one is that because there is no solar and there is no wind in this cave, another good option might be biofuel refining in order to make chem fuel. That way we can take fungus or meat, turn it into chem fuel, and power through a chem fuel generator. Batteries would also be a very good research project, because if we're generating power, we're surely going to have excess power. So it's very helpful to store the excess power somewhere so it's not wasted, because generating power is very expensive. There's also drug production. So drug production leads to rad pills, which is important in order to fight radiation and also to make things like gas mask filters. So that's another good one. I don't think that it's going to be easy to get cycad brewing or beer brewing because of the light level restrictions. A grow light would be incredibly expensive to have. Maybe at some point we will have the wealth to do that, but that's not that likely anytime soon. All right, and then there's also the possibility of introducing microelectronics. Jumping straight to the high-tech age for a high-tech research bench to increase our research speed. Or other, and then something that the viewers suggest. You guys. So first research project, give me 5 minutes to vote on that. All right, while you vote on that, I am going to set up some additional grow zones. So this will be for glowstool as well. This will be for glowsteel as well. Any really small zones like this, I'm gonna set up as tree roots, giant roots. Let's put Angel Strand there and Heal Shroom. This will be also Heal Shroom. Single zones I'm going to put as tree roots, and then anything larger than a single spot will be something else. Giant roots, much like trees in RimWorld, do not work, do not produce resources when grown on top of one another, so it's important to space them out. Which is why all of these little single zones here are becoming giant roots, and then the zones that are adjacent to one another can become something else. Like, whoa, Jesus, crazy, Dave, holy cow, cheers. All 50 of those community subs. My goodness. You are here, dude. Thank you. Thank you so very much. I do hope that those that are being generous fare quite well in the raffles. Not to say that I'm admitting to rigging them. I'd like to think I don't. Well, actually, when I do, I usually admit that I do, but good luck nonetheless. You all deserve it. This is very much a community supported channel, so without you all, I would be doing something else, probably having a lot less fun too. So yeah, this is painstaking work trying to designate each grow zone. But there really isn't a economical alternative because of how little soil there is. If I was in a lush cavern, it would be a little bit easier. But I picked this type of cavern on purpose because of its resource scarcity. Much the way that I like, you know, CI survival and the like, right? You can think of this as sort of a variation of CI survival, I suppose. Okay, so I have my horseshoe pin, and then I have this laid out so oddly here so I could stick a chess table there. I don't have the steel for that, so I'm going to have to mine for that. Oh, one big thing that I wanted to do is to switch around my sleep-work schedule. The reason being, at night, most of the animals, despite the fact that there's really no day-night cycle, are nocturnal. So if I switch around my sleep schedule where I am diurnal, is that the opposite? I can avoid being eaten by bears and the like. We don't need to move because of the lack of radiation protection of this tile. Yes, so if I wanted to get to a lush cavern, it would be up the road, and it would be possible to do, but I wanted to do it with the difficulty of living in a not lush cavern. Just call me a sadist, I guess, or a masochist. All right, the poll for what research to get nearly concluded. And I'm just running around planting what I can. Just rad things, exactly. Now, if you're trying this for yourself, you're absolutely welcome, if not even encouraged, to do lush caverns, as it will be easier. But do not start on a non-cavern tile. Unless you know what you're doing, because you'll just get irradiated and die. Think of it as like a toxic fallout ramped up to 5. Emily, thank you for the resub all 10 months. And X42, cheers. And Kitchenhead, too. And Tosca Cake, thank you for the follow. And Klim Klimic. I hope your parents didn't name you Klim Klimic. But I guess it didn't hold someone like Chris Christofferson back, so maybe it wouldn't matter. Cheers. Oh, I don't like that noise. So, biofuel refining has 1. Tick that off the list. And I'm going to stick that here. So, the power generation that I have available to me is wood fire or chem fuel powered. I could do wood fired if I have enough giant roots to fuel it. But chem fuel is a pretty good alternative. Okay, there's already heal shroom there, so I'm going to leave this as heal shroom so we don't kill it. And then this will be giant roots. Cheers. I had a sister that lived in like a real life toxic wasteland for 2 years. The industrial capital of China, not known for its clean air. I remember visiting her, and the night sky was like a deep orange color. It didn't get black, it just was orange. Like a burnt orange shade. It was really something to behold. The air was like a little metallic. And then if you know when you like lactic burn after exercising really hard? If you took a deep breath, it would kind of feel like lactic burn or something like that. It was unpleasant. There's a lot of parts of China that are lovely, but that part was not so much. So let's switch around my day-night cycle so that we can avoid some of the megafauna that would want to chew my bones. Like the irradiated bear or the warts. Yo, do you want a treat? Here you go, guy. Look at him. I'm not the best artist. I tried with this Yoda creature here. Look at him zip around. Dude, it's bedtime. Where are you going? Yoda needs in-game bed? Oh, once I'm able to afford it. You better believe he's gonna get one. Oh, there is a zone down there that I did not see. Alright, nearly done sewing. Now I'm gonna build a kitchen. So this little zone here is cleaner than the other zones. In fact, hold on, before I even do that, I'm gonna switch around how I'm doing home zoning. Because obviously I don't want to be responsible for cleaning up the whole cave. That's a bit much. So let's paint the home zones only on the doors. And then also everything in here to keep this clean. So those are my only doors. Yes. Yes. Frost Lamb and Crimson Rust. Thanks. You're just looking delicious right now. Excuse you. He heard you. I mean, look at the sizes of his ears. Alright, looks like the bear is asleep. So, Mr. Rad, let's try to go mining. Right now I'm mining so that I can build up the resources for a hand tailor bench, a butcher table, and then also a fueled stove. The fueled stove's probably going in here somewhere, like that. And I'm trying to use the light given off by the glow shrooms in order to work so that I can see my work environment. How long until corpses rot? They're probably rotting pretty soon. Like one day, yep. So the butcher table is going to be first, so we can stave off from the rot. Stay asleep. You better stay asleep. I'm going to forbid that steel so we don't go running for it as long as I'm controlling. So area one is going to be Yoda's zone. And also to note, this is Yoda's little cavern. This is the name of my home here. I'm going to create another zone called Inside. So the inside zone is just going to be everything that's behind my walls. So that if there's a manhunter or something a bear trying to eat me or something like that, I can very quickly zone myself indoors and not have to worry about swinging doors open and getting chomped on. Because every time I die, the threat skill goes up. Wrong one. That's the butcher table. And I do have enough for the butcher table, so we'll get that going. Butcher creature forever. Ingredient radius, small. One of the reasons to have a small ingredient radius is I don't want to go running around the cavern to animals that have been killed by other predators, because that'd be a really good way to become prey yourself. So at the moment, here's an example of a warg and a irradiated mega spider obviously murdering one another. And I would not want to run over there to go butcher them, because that would be a terrible idea. All right, instead of relaxing socially, 7 in the morning, you know what? I'm going to stay inside. So schedule inside, because the bears are up and around. And I'd rather not get eaten. So I have about 2 days to be able to cook that food and... Oh yeah, here. They're already starting to eat rats and moles and the like. If I wanted an animal bed, I could do an animal sleeping box. Rather inexpensively for Yoda. There we go. There's still more sewing to be done. And this stockpile's looking too small. There is no way Iskandia to unroof anything on these map tiles. They are impossible to get sunlight. The thin rock roof here is not removable. So if you try to go remove roof, the moment you remove one roof, it's just instantly re-roofed. And you'll never break out. There is no escape. Yeah, you can see these predators going on the march for murdering rats. I think rats are some of the first prey. Really not safe out there, is all I'm trying to say. Yeah, I was when I was first learning the Rad World mod, I thought to myself, oh yeah, maybe I can... Maybe I'll just be able to build solar by breaking through the roof. Here, let me demonstrate for you so you can see what it looks like. Oh, it's back. It's back. It's still back. It's always back. It never, ever gets removed. So... A raid of Pezic Coalition. Pezic Coalition. Oh, here's a really good example. So Pezic Coalition, to the red, is... And I didn't go over the factions. They are a native faction here that are mutated. They're fierce mutants. So if you take a look at him, he has enlarged ears and a large stomach. But a mutant brain and an irradiated brain. So he has a very low efficiency brain, which should be very easy for me to kill him. Covered in scaly skin, so he is armored as a result, with some deformed lungs as well. I'm not exactly sure how he's pathing to me. But we do know that we're going to have to deal with that. If it became mutated, would I change to Rodomont and live in a sewer and you'd have to kill me for skill books? No. That's not true. That was Rodament. R-A-D-A-M-E-N-T. Unrelated. Coincidental similar names. All right, so he's probably headed to this door here. So let's go deal with that now. I'm gonna leave this door open for him, so I have a longer wind up. Good. Shot at nothing. Come on, Abanero. All right, left both doors open. Luckily, I'm much faster than he is, but he's got armor, so it's hard to get through his armor, as you can see. All I did in that shot was shoot off his nose. Ratty's got your nose. Another thing that should be obvious to most of you is that... oh, don't light that on fire. Without the ability to have power, mini turrets aren't that useful. Deadfall traps, still totally useful. Can you stop lighting things on fire, you little mutant? You're gonna make my cave really hot. There we go, that was good shots. He's basically dead now. I think he was trying to eat me and was scared off by my gunfire, so that was fortuitous. All right, let's get these fires under control, and Abanero, I will watch you die. Here, go eat Abanero. Don't touch me. I'll shoot you later, dude. Is you gonna eat Abanero? Oh no, you're gonna eat my fungus. Alright, I don't want to have to deal with more of the bugs. So, let me try to land high damage here. Flush him out, because I don't want them in my neighborhood. I'm not a Mr. Rogers for scary bugs. He is dormant, but it does pose a threat to Yoda, who I am gonna put in here, closing the door, so that the Mega Spider cannot go hunting Yoda. Good. Good opening fire. It is pretty wounded. I like how Mr. Abanero decided to bring in some lovely jade for me. It's also nighttime, so most of the other animals are asleep, meaning that, they shouldn't be buggers trying to come eat me. See if I can't beat them to this door. Nope, doesn't look like it. I'll take you this way. Another thing that might be occurring to most of you RimWorld veterans is that being in darkness means that animals have the move speed advantage. Obviously not wounded ones, but in the dark, animals don't move slower, but humans do. So my move speed is fast when I am around the mushrooms at 4.6. But then as soon as I'm back into the dark, I'm stumbling around and I don't know where I'm going. So my move speed drops to something like a 3.6. because of the multiplier for light here. So I have to be really cautious about how dark the environment is when I'm fighting these things, because they have the upper hand constantly. And these are mutated insects. Oh, those are good shots. And it's dead. All All right, Mr. Pezza. You came naked, so there's nothing even to strip. What I will do is dump your body out here, because God knows you are going to be eaten very quickly by the wild animals. I could get medical XP, but, why not? Why not get... Oh, he's so dead so quickly. I don't know if I could even get medical XP off of him. Nope, he's dead. Well, let nature have him now. And I'm also going to just clean up some of the nastiness that happened around here, just so that the bedroom zone here is not so nasty. Just some spot cleaning. Unfortunately, because I dragged the insect around for a bit of a kiting, there is a lot more filth kind of everywhere. And, yep, look at him. Habanero. He's gone. Recycled. That's why we don't go out in the dark. Because creepy creatures won't eat you. Can Yoda eat the insect meat? Yoda can, yeah. So I'm going to change the Yoda zone to include just here, like that. And then also to be able to path to his own bedroom. All right, my needs are going to be sleep right now. Oh, good. Yoda got the flu. The first tending I'm going to do with Glow World meds, and then each tending after that, probably just manual. Give him a nice head start. Alright, the current project now is build production facilities. Build a kitchen, I think, yeah, is the primary. I'll leave that up. I do need a stove to be able to process this meat, which is going to spoil really soon. Most of these animals are in some sort of stage of malnutrition, because there's not a lot of food, so soon there's going to be a great kill-off where they're going to murder one another until there's very few left, or they leave the map tile. Cheers. Can we feed Yoda mutant people? We could. I just can't. Well, there's no rules against me butchering the mutants, but there is the psychotic break issues of me butchering the mutants. And the problem with the psychotic break would be that I'm alone. So if I psychotically break and I wander off and get myself killed, the game becomes harder. So I'm going to try not to do that. Bumbleb. Bumbleb. Thank you for the sub, the resub. Alright, creatures should be going to sleep soon here. It's 8 p.m. As soon as they hit the hay, I'll do some more mining. And maybe I'll actually get someone to join me. It's kind of a fat chance, but you never know. I'm also gonna mine here, see where this leads. Hey, solar flare! Okay, cool. A little bit more cave. All right, creatures, are you asleep? You are. Good. might not be a bad idea to work towards a duster and or cowboy hat, because it is rather hot and I'm sleeping unpleasantly warm. He's a very well-trained Yoda. That he is. All right, fueled stove time. Do I have 80? Yes, I do. I'm actually going to move the kitchen in here, because there's light level here. And then I think what I'll do is I'll steel door this off and try to make this more sterile to limit food poisoning. I have 2 hours until this food spoils, so bulk simple meal as fast as you can with meat only. It's gonna spoil before I even... Oh, God, no, not that kind of meat. One hour left. Plenty of time. And I'm only gonna end up having 3 meat spoil. So, food restrictions here. New food restriction, simple meals. Clear all and allow only simple meals. And then let's delete the other ones. There we go. Are they? Yeah, they're back awake. Well, I've made pretty much no progress on research so far, so that's going to be a bit of a priority here in a minute. There we go. Feed Yoda the insect meat. Perfect. He doesn't mind, and I definitely don't want it. Put Yoda on research. He's a smart boy, but I don't know if he's that kind of smart. So, numbers for animal corpses. Wow, there's none right now. That's how carnivorous this cavern is. Yikes. Oh, and a pet Yoda. Sorry, that's overdue. Hey, buddy. So, checking in on his flu. He's 33 over 15. It's not bad. How big is his map? 300 by 300. Doing a little bit of cleaning because it got a little gross. There we go. What am I doing now? Hauling the cloth? All right. And then it should be up to research. Yes, it is indeed. Yeah, are they asleep? They're not asleep yet. I would like a chess table so I don't get bored of playing horseshoe pin. And I've not spent even a second on biofuel finding yet. He looks like a thrumbo without a horn. That he does. All right, so let's prioritize research over hauling and cleaning. Because we've just been stuck cleaning. And as soon as the external creatures go to sleep, I will, I'll hit up some mining as well. Crazy Dave, thanks for gifting out yet another sub. Alright, Yoda. 12 hours until next tend, that's not bad. And it looks like things just went to sleep, so... 1, 2... I'm actually gonna mine 3 sections. Trying to get most bang for my buck out of it. Haven't really leveled up in anything. Not yet, at least. Howdy, Mike. All right, this will go for the chess table. How are you hauling the forbidden steel? I have no idea. Oh, I don't have enough steel for the chess table now, so let's do another mine for that. Thank you for tuning in to the RimWorld miniseries marathon winner for May, Escape the Tomb World, which originally streamed live on Twitch May 21st and May 22nd. If you have any feedback or questions for me, let me know in the comments below, but please keep in mind that this series has since ended its streams only once. If you would like to catch a live stream of mine, Rodomont.com has my stream schedule and countdown timers to upcoming streams. If you would like to join my gaming community, Rodomont.com or the description of this video have a link to Discord. Thank you so very much for watching. A special thank you to all my Patreon patrons, Twitch subscribers, and people that turned out to this live stream, as well as viewers like you on YouTube. Thank you so very much. I hope to catch you next episode or another series on Twitch. Farewell.